So today is Friday, April 23rd, and this is a 90/365 Loving Me video, and I haven't been around much, moving a lot of things around, getting my blog off of the Ning Network, because Ning has decided that they are going to charge. They're no longer offering the free service, so getting my network moved, actually just moving my blog to my website where my regular blog is, and really dealing with having to say goodbye to something that was very much the beginning of my work, was the beginning of Project Kenji Cat, Do Something Saturday, Unplugging HIV. It is the beginning. There's a lot of pictures there. There's a lot of everything there. And I've made some amazing friends there through Project Kenji Cat. Dab Garner, Fawa. Just some amazing people who I know will always be in my life, no matter what. And there's also friends that are there on Project Kenji Cat who are actually in my life and are my friends. Tina and Andy, Ryan and Moina, Eric. There's just so many people there, and it's been tough. And I had hoped to have it completed by now, but it's tough going through. I think there's over 500 blogs there, and having to move them one by one, making sure everything stays intact in the transition. It's been a lot of work, and it's been a complete learning process for me, and looking through the blogs and seeing people who were in my life and for one reason or another transitioned out, or I just decided, you know what, this serves no purpose, so I transitioned them out. And I look at what remains, and as I transition off of the Ning Network, I'm also seeing that people are transitioning out. And some of them, I'm happy they're transitioning out, for one reason or another. And others, I'm sad to see them transitioning out. But in order for me to grow, some things need to be removed. And some people need to be removed. And it's something that I talk about in my blog. It is something that I talk about here on YouTube. And it's something that I'm constantly doing, and that's evolving, growing. And with growth, for me, moving into greater works, some things just can't stay. Some people just can't stay. And I'm reminded of a scenario that my mom told me, where she said sometimes people in your lives are only there for a season. As things change, they're gone. As soon as the wind shifts or your tree starts to shake and move and get battered, then those people are gone. Those are the people that you're never going to be able to depend on. Those are the kinds of people that are fine when the tree is steady, when everything is calm. But let some trembling come, let some shaking of the foundation come, and those people will scatter like flies. She said what's left are true friends, people who are truly there for the right reasons. And as I look at all my blog entries that are on Ning and everything that's happened in my life, there's been some people who have stepped into my life for the wrong reasons. They stepped into my life in hopes of changing me into what they wanted. They stepped into my life because I was a project. I was broken in their eyes. I was someone who needed their friendship, who needed their expertise, who needed their help, who needed their guidance. And once they realized that I didn't need any of that, then they had no use for me. Or people that came into my life and thought, well, this will make him better. Me being in his life is going to make his organization better. And those people are gone. And what I'm left with are these amazing people who love me unconditionally. All my faults, all my flaws, all my shortcomings, all my bad tempers, all my everything. They love me as I am. For all the bad, for all the good, they love me. They're my friends. And I'm happy to say that even here on YouTube, I know that there's people that are in my life for the right reasons, and there are people that will remain in my life. And when I think of people like Jackie, like Purple Kisses, Joyce, like Leah, when I think of people like Everett, when I think of people like that, I'm just so encouraged. Last night I had the chance to just sit and chat and laugh and have the best time with another amazing friend, and that's my friend Audrey. And just laughing, and I so needed to laugh last night. I'm so busy preparing for my trip to Washington, and there's just so much that I have to do, and it's a very, very important trip. I'm getting to go to the White House, and I'm worried about Dodger. It's like I'm leaving my child behind. And it's almost like he knows it. And there's just so much that I have to prepare for in going to Washington. And in moving my blog from Ning or leaving behind my network, seeing comments that people make, hearing comments that people make about things that affect me. And it really calls into question their loyalty, so to speak, or their friendship. I can agree to disagree with a friend. But when something is going to cause great harm to a friend, I can't sit on the side of that harm and be okay with that. I just can't. It's just who I am. If I know that what is about to take place, and I'm just going to use an example, is going to hurt my friend Darlena, I can't sit by and do like this and sit on the side of all that harm and agree with it. I just can't do that. I can't do that. That's not who I am as a person, and it's not who I am as a friend. And this whole month, I've been doing some spring cleaning, weeding out, getting rid of some things. The season has changed, and people, places, and things have to change. And I'm looking at what was before me, the seat on the HIV commission, and then have it not happen, and being a little bit bummed, actually a lot bummed about that. But then looking at what's taking place right now, and realizing that people, places, and things that aren't supposed to stay in my life or remain in my life, as long as I stay focused on what it is I'm doing, everything around me has to fall into place. And I am so happy with that. Somebody just told me, and this is a person that has transitioned out, and it is a person that I knew I needed to transition out, told me that I was transparent. And I didn't take that as an insult, even though they meant it as one. And when I listened to what they had to say, and at the end of the conversation, I said, you know what? Well, I would much rather be transparent, and I want people to see me as very transparent. I would much rather be transparent than superficial. And that was the end of the conversation. And it wasn't meant to attack. It wasn't meant to hurt this person. It was just meant to be what it was. I like being transparent. I don't ever want to be a superficial person. I don't ever want what I do to be about me getting some political position or getting my face on some newspaper or getting recognition for something. My work and what I do is about humanity, and I always want that to be the core. I don't want to die tomorrow. If I were to die tomorrow, I don't want people to say, oh, he was on this magazine. I don't want people to say, oh, all he cared about was this. I want people to say, he worked hard, and he did great things while he was here. He left a legacy, and I don't want my legacy to be superficial. Peace and blessings, everybody.